welcome to yet another Doctor Who DVD review. In this DVD review, I should be looking at Survival, the final story of the classic series. I'm going to look at the cover first, then the booklet, then the discs, and then my thoughts on this story. So, at the top, we have the standard grey TARDIS roundels. We have Ace, a cheetah person, we have the Master there, Sylvester McCoy, and a skull. That's probably one of my favourite moments from the story. And then we have some volcano sort of erupting, and we have a yellow Sylvester McCoy banner there with his date, PG. And on the spine, we've got a picture of a horse there, what the cheetah people rode. Well, we've got a cheetah person on that horse, sorry. And on the back, we have Sylvester McCoy, the Master, and some various other characters like Midge and the Captain, by Rona Munry. So if you want to know what the story's about, feel free to pause it. And it was first broadcast on the 22nd of November to the 6th of December 1989, and the total running time for this is 72 minutes, sorry. It's a three-part story. Let's go and have a look at the discs and the book. Okay, so now to the booklet, we have the production note, and we have a picture of, again, the same picture of Sylvester McCoy there, with the cheetah eyes and the skull. So if we open this up, we have the extras with commentary with Sylvester McCoy, Sophie Aldred and Andrew Cartmell. We have Cat Flap making of Survival, deleted and extended scenes. Outtakes, that is definitely worth a watch. I believe some of these Survival outtakes are on YouTube and they are funny. Sylvester McCoy is just quite comedic. He shows his comedic side in the outtakes. And we have the continuity announcements. Then we have the 5.1 sound, music only option, production subtitles, photo gallery, Radio Times billings, Doctor Who The End Game, a 45-minute documentary that looks in detail about the reasons why Doctor Who was cancelled. Search Out Science, where Sylvester McCoy stars as the Doctor doing a little educational thing with K-9 involved in it. And then we have A Little Girl Lost, where it looks about Sophie Aldred's character Ace development and destiny of the Doctor as a sort of insert with the Master. Also, Doctor The Endgame hints at the future season 27. Stories like Ice Time, what would later be adapted to Thin Ice, and stories like introducing the new companion, such as Rain in Crime of the Century. But luckily Big Finish have done those stories, so we can see what the story, well, that season was like. So that's basically the features. Then we have the chapter points there and some more of the pictures from the story itself. Now the discs, because it is a two disc set, what it doesn't say on the cover, but the discs are exactly the same. I don't really need to go into detail about them. So that's basically the disc, well, the discs and the booklet. So now let's go to my thoughts on this final classic Doctor Who story. Okay, so what are my thoughts on Survival? This story is not the grandest of finishes for Doctor Who, but at the time they didn't actually realise that this was going to be the last story of Doctor Who, hence why they already planned season 27. But when they got the sort of vague hint that Doctor Who may not, might not be returning, they decided to dub that speech as Sylvester McCoy going, "There are some worlds out there where the sky is whatever the speech was." And we've got the Doctor and Ace walking off, which I suppose is nice, you know, but you can still imagine that they're doing adventures even the show's finished. But other than that, it's a brilliant story. The story itself has some quite adult themes, you know, it's quite nitty-gritty, but the adult themes are quite sort of undercurrents in the story. Now the story, like most Seventh Doctor stories, are about Ace, and this story really just shows the evolution of the character. It shows where she came from in Perivale, and there's one line in this when she was possessed by the cheetah person, but she could run forever, and I think that sort of links in with Ace leaving Perivale, that she could, she's running away from Perivale for as far as she can. She just wants to be away from Perivale because she, you know, she could run forever just to get away from it, but, you know, you can't hide your past. And I just think that sort of a nod to Ace's past, that she tried to run away from Perivale, but Perivale always catches up with her. Yes, so Sylvester McCoy himself gives a valiant performance, with him being quite the alpha male in this story, with him, you know, shouting and being quite dark as ever, but this story really just shows his dark side, especially when he's got the cat sort of contact lenses in, and it just makes him look even more sort of dark, and you know, you can see the evilness of that doctor. Not what he's meant to be, but you can see why he's sort of dark and evil. And this being him sort of being the alpha male character, he does clash with the captain or sergeant character, which is just brilliant. And Sylvester McCoy does get some sort of comedic moments, especially with the cat food, you know, that sort of scene. Anthony Ainley, fantastic as ever. And that the cat contact lenses just make him even more eerie. The performance is just even more eerie. Yeah, the cheetah people, I do like them. They're good villains. I think they're quite good. I mean, the idea of using an everyday object like the Jadoon being a rhino, and then rhino cops and stuff like that. And using black cats to teleport, because black cats are seen as sort of very superstitious in people's eyes, you know. So I think that makes that even more eerie, but, you know, using everyday objects. What I do love, as I've said in previous reviews, that using everyday objects just makes Doctor Who even more scarier. Yeah, so overall, this is a brilliant story, and I highly recommend it, because it is a quite a good story, but it is a final classic series story, so I think that's a major selling point. And I've always enjoyed this story, and I will continue to enjoy it. So yeah, so this has been my review of Survival. Definitely check it out, because it's a final classic story, and it's quite good to finish off the classic series, but not the grandest of finales most fans would have hoped for. But you just forget, at the time they didn't really know that, so yeah. This has been my review of Survival. My next review is the Series 2 opener of Lucy Miller Adventures, which is Dead London. So join me in that review, which will be coming very soon. But for now, I shall bid you a farewell. So, goodbye.